Hi one and all, myself Brahmesh SM. I have already shared two videos with you which help every student to know how and where to fetch the resources for the course titled as Robotic Process Automation. So through this video we shall start the journey in the semester to understand an interesting course called Robotic Process Automation. So before starting the journey, every student should know what would be the outcome of this course. I mean, what actually the student will learn from this course. This is the one that we need to address first before starting the journey. The main outcome of this course, or the first outcome of the course titled as Robotic Process Automation, is you will learn, a student will be aware of a new technology called RPA technology. The second outcome of this course is the student will learn how to use this RPA technology to build a robot. So remember, in this course, whenever I say robot means, don't think we are discussing about the mechanical or a hardware robot. Instead, we are discussing about a software robot. So these are the two important outcome of this course. I mean, at the end of this course, every student will be aware of a new technology called RPA technology, and every student will be in a position to build software robot using RPA technology. So with this introductory, we shall start the journey to understand an interesting course, as I said, called Robotic Process Automation. So first we shall start with an very basic or an introductory chapter for the course Robotic Process Automation, titled as What is Robotic Process Automation. So the roadmap of this presentation, of this chapter, is first we will discuss about what is Robotic Process Automation means. Then we will discuss an interesting question called why do we need robotic process automation. Then we will discuss the scope and techniques of automation. Then we will discuss about UiPath platform. Finally, we shall conclude this chapter by discussing the future of automation. But in this video, I will address only one the outline of this chapter called what is robotic process automation. So now we shall understand what is actually robotic process automation means. So I won't read the statement present in the slide here. Anyhow, you can get this later either in the PPT or in the textbook. So in a simpler words, robotic process automation can be understood as like this. So usually robotic process automation will be used by organizations or industries in order to automate the task done by the human being. But remember, not all the tasks done by the human being. I will redefine this as the classes goes on, but for the time being, this is the high level definition for robotic process automation. Means usually organization, as I said, or the industries will use RPA technology in order to automate the task done by the human being. Remember, not all the tasks. We shall redefine it as the classes goes on. In other way, we can understand RPA, or we can define RPA as the main goal of robotic process automation is to replace the repetitive and interesting boring task performed by humans. Okay, I will give a simple example for this. Let us assume myself as an employee of a department of IS&D, and my job role is every day I need to log into an account, email account, let us call it abc@pac.ac.in. Every day I have to log into that account and have to go through all the new mails in that account, and I need to select the important mails in that account, and then I need to forward those emails to HOD and finally logged out from the account. So this is the task that I have to do every day morning in the department. Did you understand the role of myself? My role is very simple: come to the college, log into the email account, and go through the new emails, select which are the important emails, forward it to the HOD account, and log out the email account. Can you say this task done by myself is a repetitive task? Because every day I have to do this. Every day I have to do this. So it is repetitive, and moreover, it is also a type of boring task for the employee. If I take myself as an employee, I feel that this job is a boring job. So these kind of tasks or jobs or a process can be replaced by software robots built by a technology called robotic process automation. So this is what actually RPA is telling here. RPA, robotic process automation technology, helps us to build a software robot which can be used in order to do the repetitive and boring task of the humans. So this is what actually robotic process automation is telling at a high level. Now we shall see what is basically, still lower level, we shall understand what is actually RPA is. See, according to the author, RPA is basically software program itself. Basically, it's a program which will run on a PC, laptop, or supercomputers or mobile device for that matter. So basically, we already also know the definition of a program is basically a set of or a sequence of instructions or commands. So basically, I hope, don't think that software robots are a new entity. It's basically a program whose job is to execute the sequence of commands given by the programmer. This is what actually RPA means at a lower level. So usually those commands will be given by the programmer and those commands will be executed by the software robots or bots. This is what the low level definition of RPA, but I will give an example for this, or I will demonstrate this definition as classes goes on in the coming classes. Finally, don't think that RPA is a program, don't think that I need to learn something new coding or new language. Don't think like that, because the author says that RPA does not require development of coding. It is not like C or C++ or Java or Python like that. It's just a drag and drop type of programming. Using drag and drop fashion of coding, we can able to build an interesting software robots, which we will see in the coming classes. And moreover, we will not worry about any access restrictions or access permission that we need to take in order to access the database or the applications in case of C or in C++. No access restrictions, no need to worry about the direct access restriction, no need to worry about syntax or you need to worry about the syntax, but not to that extent like C or Python or Java. To that extent, it's just a very simple way of programming, or a visual more specifically RPA technology is a visual programming technology which can be used by the programmer to build software robots. I will demonstrate what is visual type of programming in the coming classes. Don't worry about that. But bottom line is very simple. This coding, RPA technology, is not boring, or it is not an hectic language to code. This is what you need to understand at this time. In the next video, we shall see, as I said, or we shall answer an interesting question called, why do we need robotic process automation, especially an enterprise or a business or an industry? Thank you one and all. If you have any queries with respect to the definition of RPA, you can please ask me through WhatsApp or through an email. Thank you one and all again.